So let's check if that makes it sound better. Hello everyone, welcome back to the Fruity Moss channel. Today, hey, let's do something new. Let's do a Happy Melody tutorial. Yeah, because last Saturday, was my birthday, which means I got older. Yay. Yeah, so let's remix Happy Birthday from memory, because I'm getting older. Let's just do a memory check if I still remember the song in the right way. So there we go. First thing we'll have to do, let's grab a synth. I'm grabbing Silent One. And let's start to remake the melody from memory. Let's start with a B. Da 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 da. Happy birthday, mother. I'm pretty sure it's in triplets because when people sing happy birthday, most of them can't really sing. So let's try to make it more swingy. So yeah, I'm pretty sure it's in triplets. So let's switch to triplets right here. So now we have that. We start on the B. We have triplets. Let's make them. Yeah, this must be all right. Okay. And then we must decide on which note the melody starts. So the kick starts at birthday. Okay. Alright. Oh crap, this is one of those melodies. Oh damn. This might work. Okay. Something like that. Okay. Yeah. Okay, and there it goes. I actually think it's a really sad melody somehow. Yeah, I mean, when we sing happy birthday to you, it all reminds us of the fact we will all die someday. Yeah, one birthday might be our last. So that's a way to cheer up this melody. Now let's find a nice bass line. I have no clue what bass line should be underneath this melody. But I do know it should be a triplet bass line. Hey. Nice, this could be the Tweekas remix actually. They like those type of bass lines. Alright, so I think we have it. I'm not sure about this one. Should be this one. Okay, so now let's split the bass line from the melody and let's start dressing up the MIDI. Okay. All right. So it should be good enough. All right, I don't think this is that bad. Yeah, so now let's do some pitch bends. So first, let's clone Silent One. I'm going to copy this MIDI, and now I'm going to create some pitch bends here. So let's set the mono legato portamento rate, time, slide, glide thing. And let's make some interesting pitch bends to make this a nice melody. Now, important with the pitch bends, make sure you hit the right note. So imagine hearing the melody. Where do you think the pitch bends should go? Somewhere like this. Yeah. I'm placing really tiny notes. I'm not sure if the length makes a lot of difference, but it's just for me to keep my stuff organized. Wow. Okay, so I think I'm trying to avoid to do a pitch bend right here because suspicions. Let's do the pitch bend on the first one. Okay, so these are the pitch bends. Let's check it one more time if it all works out and that kind of stuff. Yeah, I think this is going to work really nice. So let's copy it back to his friends. Now he isn't alone anymore. And let's start making some chords. Now the reason I kept the previous MIDI without the pitch bend notes is so I don't have to remove the pitch bend notes now, because chords and pitch bend notes, yeah, I don't know, can be a real mess sometimes. Okay, so let's match this up with the bass line. I recently discovered there's a really fast way to do this, but I sort of like doing this knowing I have a keyboard that works, because that seems to be rare these days. I really enjoy drinking beer sometimes, but you know, that's why I buy multiple keyboards at a time. You do the math. Now, okay, so this should work for the chords. Alright, so the chords might give some stuff away. Yeah, so that's where it should be. Okay, let's test it again. Oh, this sounds terrible. Let's make a decent bass line. Because this is a happy melody that's used the tweaker type stuff. I didn't do a bassline preset in my Fruity Master Silent One Bank. Yeah, I'm not advertising or something. It's just that I really like the Fruity Master Silent One Bank. Okay, so let's find a nice preset in the Fruity Master Silent One Bank. You can find it in the description, of course. Now, I think it's the popcorn bass. Yes. Damn, that's low. Fucking shit. Die treinen. Same baseline. Okay, let's check this out. This is going so well. Okay, so let's do the chords. Let's make sure. Yeah, let's make some chords. So I don't know music stuff. Yeah, of course I know music stuff. I know a little bit about music theory. I know a coffee machine can be explained by music theory. I do know how to make it working without knowing how to explain it. So I can explain you my process of making chords. I simply drag them below, because one of the things I've heard, or perhaps I've noticed it myself, the top melody line in your chords is the one you hear. So because we know this one, we can more easily focus on the other stuff. But this is a really tricky melody. Yeah. So the thing I'm doing when I'm dragging notes around and when it sounds really weird, that's just for me, because I know which notes are in the in the Netherlands it's called the tone ladder. In the key, I think. Yeah, I go like. Now, this is also something D-Tunes does. When you watch one of his videos, he has this really fucked up ghost notes on his background here in the playlist. But that's actually really smart. But I just don't want to do that, because I'm not really... I'm in the state of denial. But yeah. That's also a river, by the way. Denial. But yeah, that's actually really smart. So perhaps you should watch one of his videos where he does it and where he explains it. Because... if you don't know what you're doing, it might really help. Getting those chords there, match them with your bass line. And after that you can simply fix your chords on the chords and the ghost notes. Is this melody major? I think it is. And there's a really nice modulation in the chords. And that's why it's not a bad melody, actually. By the way, I'm drinking American beer right now, but I'm not going to tell which brand it is. You get it? I think these chords work, but we will find out when we are doing the harmonies, because then we will be focusing on other parts in the melody. Now, let's grab this bank again by this awesome guy, and let's pick heady chords. Alright, let's lower down the release. I do think we should go transposing up a little bit. Yeah. So let's do that for the other guys, so we can lower the bass again. So, something like this. Now, so I just grabbed my own preset heady chords. I've noticed two layers go really well with it. One is the Nexus single layer lead 6. The other one is my third or maybe fourth Spire preset from my very tiny bank. Well, I always think it's really small, but it's actually, there are some presets in here. Most of them I haven't heard in a while. Let's check them out. I don't know. Now the thing I like about Spire, it's a really different type of synthesizer than compared to Serum or Silent. It really has its own sound. And that's something I really like about Spire. That's why I have it. That's why I made some presets for it. And it also, they say it closely resembles the sound of the Virus TI. Now I can't say that for sure because I don't have a Virus TI yet. I'm saving money up for it. And by then, I'll do a comparison video comparing the Virus TI to plugins. People claim that sound like the Virus TI. Whatever. Okay, so I think this one will really go well. Something I've learned from Wildstyles. He uses the Virus to fill up his chords. And now if Spire does resemble a Virus, then it might also work the same way. So this is just Silent, and this is with Spire. So you can really hear they need each other, because when you disable one of them, you can hear the difference, and it doesn't sound that great anymore. So that's good layering. So let's copy these ones back over here. Ah, yeah, that's it. Okay, so we'll need to fix a bassline here. So, yeah. That's a really nice start, actually, for melody. Let's start naming stuff. This is the bass line, because it's bass and it's also a line. These are the chords. Let's give them no name, because I'm throwing them in the same mixer channel. Because they are both chords. Let's merge them together, like, I don't know. Let's name this one lead 1, because it's the first lead. We could also name it lead, because there's only one lead. It's the same reason Sunday is called Sunday and not Sun's Day, because back in the day we figured, hey, there's only one sun. Now we know multiple stars are, most of them are actually bigger than our sun. So it should be Sun's Day now, but yeah, who wants that, right? So let's find a nice lead, and I'm going to do something I have never done before in a video. I'm going to drag this one here all the way to the right, so it's really purple. So what does it do? It makes everything mono. One thing with hardstyle, and I think hardstyle is the worst genre when it comes down to phasing, when you layer multiple leads together. When your melody, when you're layering sounds nice and mono, it will almost always sound better in stereo. But when it sounds nice in stereo, that's no guarantee that it will sound nice in mono. So, yeah, having a stable mono melody makes your melody better mixed or something. I don't know, but I love layering in mono. Okay, so let's grab a nice lead. The Savannah lead seems to be popular, but I'm going to make a new one. Okay. I could have used the original in it, by the way. Let's grab pitch A, because we only have A. You could also do A, B, whatever. That option is only there for really complex stuff. Okay, let's grab... There's another train coming. Damn! How long have I been recording, actually? So we want to create a bit of an LFO effect. I think this is just beautiful. I'm sorry. When you look up the left here, yeah, I gave the name. Let's go to 128D. I don't know. I really like the Enterprise D. Right. This is the range and this is the gain. This is how much influence this has. And this is how much range it has. I think it could use just one knob. But perhaps it shouldn't. Yeah. Now you get this really dirty lead compared to this or this. I think it's nice. So let's give it a little bit of a pitch attack. Okay, because it's the tweaker style melody, it could be. Let's give it this plucky sound. Because right now it goes like... But let's make it go... down. Like a happy tree. No, hanging tree. So yeah. And now this is the point where we start layering it with other leads. And after that, let's do the harmonies. So the first thing I usually do, I clone this up and I grab my saw lead. Now, keep in mind, we are doing this in mono. So it will sound strange, perhaps. Okay, let's enable them together. Oh, this is going to be so much fun. Now, let's do another lead, because this layering is going well. Let's grab hanging tree. Now this lead might sound a bit similar to this one. So let's check out if they are not phasing. Okay, a little bit, so let's give this one a bit more. Now, perhaps you guys don't know this yet, but once we throw this one back to stereo again, it will sound so very, very sweet. So that's the fun about layering in mono. When it sounds good in mono, yeah, once you're done and you reset this knob here, it sounds so much better. It already sounds incredible. Might be a really nice trick for those who don't know how to layer properly. There's another train coming. All right, so we have this. Sounds great in mono. Let's find our... super saw, and let's do the harmonies. So, to keep my stuff organized, I will call this harmony 2, and I'll clone it again, and I'll call it harmony 1. I'm not sure if the tweakers actually do harmonies, but perhaps they do, but turn them down really soft. What? Please turn the volume softer. English, you know. Okay, so Harmony, no, let's start with Harmony 2. I'll explain why. Because when we go down one, that's actually the second harmony, because the chords are different now. Okay, so let's simply match them up. Don't worry about too much about the pitch notes. And in case you don't know if it should go up or down, the second harmony should be in the middle when you do it my way. So yeah, there should only be three notes visible. When I pull down my pants, there should only be two notes visible. Now, something like this. Screw it, let's do it this way. And now let's do the first harmony. So let's go all the way here. This is really easy. I could actually edit this out of the video, but let's check it out with the harmonies. And let's throw the first one, let's transpose it up one octave. And let's enable the second one. The important part with this, only enable the leads, only enable the harmonies, set it to mono, and make sure it sounds nice. Whenever you think, hey, this doesn't really sound nice, it probably doesn't sound nice, so fix it. So let's make sure the chords aren't too loud. Probably are. Let's play everything. Alright, so here comes the big surprise. Let's reset it. Now it's stereo again. Just hear the difference. This is how it sounds mono. And this is stereo, people. Yeah, so that's a big difference. It instantly sounds better, in my opinion again. But yeah, so let's throw everything into the mixer. And after that, we might want to add some pads or something. Let's make this bus again. Let's just name it Melody. I used to name it Leads and Chords, but hey, together they are the melody. So bassline isn't a part of that. Sorry, bassline. I'm kicking you out of the group. And I'm going to throw them all to the melody bus. Now, I've noticed we are clipping a little bit. Let's throw down the volume. Not the bus, because that's where they go, because if you lower down the bus also, it will sort of multiply your actions. So be careful with that. Okay, and now is the time to turn off your mind. This is Hardwit style. Sorry. To create some pads. Let's make it all easy bit again. So let's make some pads. Let's first, when I do pads, the first thing I usually do is the bass line. I'm thinking about doing, how are they all working out? Is this the most predictable melody ever or something? What the f... Alright. So let's do a chord inversion to make it more interesting. Good enough. So for this I'm going to grab contact, replacing it with contact, I was working on a really nice pad setting for Silent One, but yeah, that's my other PC, and it might crash somewhere this month or something, so I'm not sure if it will survive that time. Okay, let's Olympus Choirs, by the way, I think it's by Sound Iron. They are not really expensive, so if you're looking for a nice choir for Kontakt, the Kontakt player is free. And you will also get a free demo bank by Kontakt. I'm pretty sure you can use it. Yeah. It's not that expensive. Not everything does has to be expensive. You know what is expensive? Buying everything. Yeah. So, let's click ensemble. Because it sounds... only the word sounds big. Okay, so let's... I like females. In a choir. And also in real life, of course. Oh crap. Inversions are... Okay. So let's name this Pets. And let's throw in another one, perhaps an organ. Lush 101, it's by D16. Those guys make some really nice plugins. I use Drummazon and Lush 101 by D16. The Lush 101 is a really nice, old-sounding synthesizer. From my experience, I have worked with the Nord 3 Stage. It's a really big red keyboard. You can also see it in the Frontliner videos. I think he has the Nord Lead, actually. But it feels so great to play it. And I can play piano, but that was a really nice day. And I think the Lush 101 sort of has the same vibe. It's not as big as the synth, of course, or keyboard, stage keyboard, but... Yeah, and Drummazon is a really simple 909 synthesizer. But let's grab a nice organ. Organ, orgasm. Sound. Keyboard. Okay. Yeah, because obviously, when it's your birthday, people are singing to you in church. To be honest, I think this is going to be a long video. Okay, so let's start mixing now. It's about time or something. Let's throw these ones back. So of course, it should sound better than this, and that's why we are going to mix right now. I'm going to do simple stuff like low cuts. This is a low cut, but you can also do a low pass, or the Jennifer low pass. Yeah, to be honest, I'm using FabFilter, and it's not a really cheap EQ, but I could for just the same results I could use this built-in equalizer, and that's not a bad equalizer. Actually, it's a really interesting fact that they built in this equalizer per mixer track, because that's how an SSL table looks like. Look it up on Google. It's a really big, fancy-looking mixer table. That is actually way simpler than FL Studio. Yeah, it looks more complex, but it's as simple as it can be. And really expensive, of course. Cutting away a low just to make sure it's not a lot of low. It might not do a lot of things for the cleanness. But yeah. I don't want low frequencies in my top leads. Chords is a really important one. Okay. Okay, so let's do the reverb. I'm going to grab my preset for this. It's perfect verb and perfect delay, but I will change it a little bit. So let's disable anything that is not in the melody box. Let's route it to the reverb just by clicking it. It's nice, but I would like to hear some reverb when the notes are playing, so I'm opening up the threshold a little bit. Okay, that's nice. This is triplets, so let's be really careful with the delay. Limiter is not enabled. I'm not sure if I would be if I should be setting this one on triplets. All right, something like that. Let's check it out again. Alright, so another thing, the pads. The pads of the hunter. No, just the pads this time. Sorry guys. It's sort of destroying the leads. So let's throw this limiter on. Well, let's show you something new. I recently got a new plugin, it's called Track Spacer. And it's really interesting. Because it only sidechains on the frequencies that are present in your leads. So when your leads are playing, it doesn't simply lower down the volume. It sort of does a perfect mix. There's another train, by the way. So let's go here to enable it. Fruity Loops can be a real bastard. Let's go here, processing, and that's... Oh, I didn't sidechain anything yet. Right mouse, sidechain to this track. Let's go here again. Now it should find one sidechain channel. Let's go back and... And this is simply the ratio. Now the leads are way stronger. Just hear the difference. Or... So that's one of my new tricks. I'm pretty sure it should sound pretty alright right now. Okay, so I'm going to set everything to mono again, disable the pads, and I'm going to check out some leads again to make it all a bit stronger. Let's clone the harmony one, something I sometimes do. And let's throw it one octave down. Minor tweaking, but now it does sound like this. Okay, not bad, right? No, but let's try something. I'm not really sure if this is going to work, but of course it's in the video, so it does work. spoiler alert, delay, I only want you, let's route the leads to the lead bus, and let's route the lead bus to the melody. They should sound the same thing right now. Cool, let's disable everything that's not leads, so. Let's make it sound the tweakers, and that's really simple. Just add the CLA 3A, and you have a the tweakers sound. Alright, so let's check if that makes it sound better. So I have to say yes. Now, thank you all for watching this video. I hope you liked it. I actually think it's one of my better tutorials, but I'll leave that up to you. So, see you again next time. There is some really cool stuff coming up. I'm actually planning lots of new tutorials, and there's going to be a new tutorial series, totally new, and it's going to be about the basics of mixing. So, I will be explaining how to use a compressor, how to use a multi-band compressor, what an EQ actually does, that kind of stuff. Because when I was looking for that on the internet, it was really hard to find the right tutorials. So I think it's about time someone shows you guys this. So I've learned about it. Let this be me. See you again next time.